You're so cute. What's your name? Hmm? Your name is Shine. Hi, Shine. Yeah.
What's going on, YouTube, and welcome back to my channel. If you've been here before, thank you for returning. If you are new to the channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on those post notifications so you are notified every single time I drop a video and you don't miss not one video. Everybody in here, smash that like button, share this video, and drop a comment down below during the video, after the video, before the video, whatever you feel. Let me know what you think. Let me know what you like about the video. Let me know what you want to see next. You saw by the title and the thumbnail, we got a good one. So let's get straight into this groom. Okay guys, so as you can see, I switched up the angle so you all are able to see everything that I'm doing. So everything on this video is going to be from the camera sitting on top of my head, because a lot of you have been requesting this angle and I already had it recorded, but I just had to get through my last few PetSmart videos. I still probably have about another maybe 10 PetSmart videos, but I didn't really care to push them out anymore because I've been gone from the company for a long time. So it was time to move on and time to get this new content out to y'all, and a lot of people seem to be happy about it. I'm really happy about it. I'm very excited for y'all to see all the grooms that I've done. I've gotten so many different types of videos for y'all set up, and next week I'm going to be putting more videos out on a more consistent basis. So right now I'm doing like a mass record, so I'm recording a whole bunch of different videos. So from here on out, you should be getting videos 3 times a week. I'm going to aim for Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, so y'all can look out for videos those days. I'm going to try and put some shorts out on Tuesday and Thursday for the people that like to see the shorts as well. So y'all stay tuned for all of that. But like I said, yes, we have a different angle. I do want to let you guys know, every video will not be this angle. Some videos will be the old style where I'm still showing me doing the paw pads. You're still able to see the paw pads. You're still able to see me do the sanitary, different things. But some of them will be from the camera angle like this, and some of them will be the old angle. But I do switch the camera around so you can see what I'm doing. But I just want to give y'all a heads up of what y'all are about to see more on the channel. Okay, getting straight into the video, this is Shiner. He, I believe, from my opinion, looking at him, he looks like a mini sheepadoodle. I'm not really sure what his breed is. I did not get a chance to ask the owner, but his name is Shiner, and I want you guys to drop in the comments and tell me why you think his name is Shiner. I did not realize it until after the second time I groomed him. Actually, it might have been the third time I groomed him that I realized why his name is Shiner. But I want you guys to drop in the comments why you think his name is Shiner. And by the end of the video, if you haven't figured it out, I will let you guys know. But this is Shiner. He's a very, very sweet boy. He was absolutely perfect for his groom, except for when he tried to jump on the table and I went to grab him so he wouldn't, and he screamed and scared me and everybody else. But like I said, he is a very, very sweet boy. He's going to be getting a teddy bear cut today. The mom dropped off and said she wanted probably about, I think, 3/8 off of him, or 3/4 off of him, something like that. Oh no, 1/3 off of him. She said she wanted 1/3 off of him, so I kind of had to guesstimate what she wanted and what kind of haircut she wanted. But at the end, he turned out so cute, you guys. I can't wait for you all to see it. He is absolutely adorable. He's such a sweet dog. He tries to avoid me at all costs because he doesn't want to get groomed. But you'll be able to see that in the video. And for this video, we're going to be starting off with his prep work. Some videos, I don't start off with prep work. I just put him straight in the tub. It just depends on the time that I have in that day. This day, I did have a little bit of time to do his prep work, so I pulled him out on the table just to get it started, and it makes the after bath process a lot quicker, so I don't spend as much time on the haircut as I would if I did not do his prep work first. So For dogs, sometimes I'll pull them out on the table and do their prep work first, which seems to be a little bit easier. Especially if the dog is bad for nails, prep work is a little bit easier to do first, because if they're bad for nails, they get stressed out, they poop, they pee, whatever. You can get all of that out the way prior to the bath, and then after the bath they're all clean, you don't have to worry about doing that again. Now, I will say I don't always do my prep work first. So if I have a dog that's bad for the nails and he pees or he poops or he drools all over his face, I do have to go clean that up, which can be a struggle sometimes, but you kind of have to gauge it to figure out which dog does that. Now, what kind of sucks is that in this camera view or the settings on the camera, you cannot tell how dirty Shiner actually is. I mean, he had gray spots, he had brown spots, he had tan spots. I mean, he looked like he had just played in the dirt prior to coming to grooming, and he was a mess. But he got really clean and bright white. Wait till you see how white his coat gets. He is a beautiful dog, very sweet, and I just can't wait for y'all to see the after process.
I'm literally not doing anything. I have to do your nails. Turn away from me. Come here. Harder on yourself. your face wet. Come here.
So for his body, as you can see here, he is pretty dirty. You can see where he's brown, he's tan, he's got some gray spots. Not the gray where he's actually gray, but he has some gray spots on his chest. Some of them just on his sides. So I'm going to be using the Hydra Whitening Shampoo, which I absolutely love. It gets them so clean. It gets them bright white, like almost like white as paper, white as snow. And it's just a really good all-around good shampoo. So that's what I'm going to be using on him while I'm washing him. So I'm putting some on his face, just in the areas where I feel like his face is really dirty, just to kind of help brighten up his fur so it's not really bright and clean on his body and his fur on the face has like a dingy tinge to it. So I'm putting some of the whitening shampoo on his face. So now I'm going to go through and put some Bark to Basics conditioner on them. It is a kiwi watermelon, I believe the scent is. I could be very wrong, but I believe the scent is around that smell. But it smells amazing, and it helps their coat soften up, and it helps to loosen any tangles that they have. So if you want a nice inexpensive conditioner, Bark to Basic has some really good products on Amazon. I just do not recommend their blueberry face wash. Something about the blueberry face wash, it just doesn't suds up enough. But it gets the face clean, but it doesn't like create like a foam. It's real weird. But they have good products overall. So coming up in like a couple seconds, my boss is actually going to step in and finish drying him because I had to walk away and work on a different dog. So right now we're going to flip to me pulling him out and starting on his groom.
Is it the both of y'all? I think it's you. I think it's you, the border collie. Okay, hold on, slow down. Yeah, you're all bright white and clean now. You was tan. Yeah, very, very dirty. Come here, you. Wait, where are you going? Okay. Oh. Yes, you are a dirty dog. Yeah, huh? Are we friends now? You've done all that squealing and everything now? Yelling at me? Yeah, it is. Definitely a lot thinner than I thought it would be. So she said a third off.
Okay, so I had to cut the audio here because we were discussing some of the client's info, so I didn't want that to be out on the internet for a free roam. So I cut the audio. I will pop the audio back in once we are done. So to create the perfect teddy bear haircut, we're going to be doing a half an inch on his body and 5/8 on his head. That is the one guard comb on his body and the zero guard comb on his head. If you guys have any questions for me or about the groom, feel free to drop them down in the comments and don't forget to smash that like button.
I think it's the border. Now come here, don't you turn away from me. Back down. Go ahead, sit back down. That Hydra is nice. Oh my gosh. Me either. This is, yeah. Yeah. Uh-huh. Oh, that's Hydra too?
Yeah, no, it's not.
Okay. Yeah, I like I'm like a shampoo snob, but I like to try out every shampoo there is out there for dogs. I love testing out different shampoos and conditioners. Like, let me see how clean it gets the dog. I love it. Yeah, that's really nice. And it smells amazing. Yeah. Yeah, she's definitely nervous, but she was nervous on the table. I guess because the table shakes a little bit. But other than that, she was perfect. She gave no issues for nothing. Yeah. kind of doodle is this one? He seems like a mini sheepadoodle. Like his coloring. Yeah. Yeah. I'm sure there is. Thank you. Right, they're back there howling together. Yes. Uh-huh. No? She's very sweet. Oh, yeah. This one right here was the one that was giving her the most trouble. She was sliding it a bit. But the other one, she was pretty, you know. Does she look okay? Oh, good, 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 good. That's how one of my dogs is at home. She will rub her head all over the carpet until it comes out. No problem. Have a good one. We're glad you found us too. Did you take half of that for washing and drying her? Oh my gosh. Yeah, me too. Yeah.
Stop it. Stop it. Stop it.
Dude, you have to get over here. You can't. I'm not chasing you around this table. I'm not going to chase you. I'm not going to chase you.
So cute.
No, come here. Boy. You know, you're very cute. You're very cute. What kind of doodle you are? Maybe an auntie doodle. Who's gonna ask? Right? You're sensitive. cute you are. Wait, I'm not done. Come here. Come here. Hold on. Brother, come here. Cute dog. He did earlier. Scared me. Oh my gosh, dude, what? What happened? He was trying to jump off the table, and I'm like, no. And he's like, ah, yes. She's trying to avoid at all costs. You can't do that. You're cute though. Right. Well, you know what's been on these floors. I can't give you none. I'm sorry. You were trying to lick my fingers. You wasn't friends with me. You were trying to avoid me, remember? Now you want my beef jerky. Smell like a dog treat, don't it? Oh, it's so good. Going. Come here. outside. Faked you right on out, didn't I?
Not gonna lie, I kind of like this angle because you can't see his completed groom before I actually reveal it. So with that being said, we're now gonna take a quick flashback look at what Shiner looked like before he got here. This is his before, and this is the big reveal. This is what he looked like after, and I think he looks absolutely adorable. He came out so beautiful. It was like the perfect haircut. His face is perfect, his ears are perfect, everything is just awesome on him. He looks too cute. Make sure you guys smash that like button, share this video, drop a comment down below, do all that fancy YouTube stuff. I love you guys. Train your dogs for grooming. Make sure you watch every video straight through. Watch those ads. Enjoy the videos. I'll catch you in the next one. Love you guys.